another musical family was having dinner together, and everyone started playing with stemmed water glasses. And I was studying piano at 6, that was not my sound. But all of a sudden, on the dining room table, that was my sound. I mean, very few people, you know, find their sound at the age of 6, but I did. And I still had to have 3 years of piano. I still had to master one instrument before I got out of school. And I'm a clarinetist. I had violin, flute lessons, and sang a lot. But I was an army clarinetist. Bought my clarinets in Paris. But still, I kept gathering more glasses. And then I found out Mozart had written four. Here's a piece that very few people have ever heard. It started with 8 glasses. Figuring out, I had the music in front of me. I started shuffling glasses around. It took me a year and 28 glasses to learn this piece. I started with these 8 glasses. So at least I could play 4 at once. Then I was playing tunes I was familiar with. You can do that with 5 glasses. Or you can add some more glasses. And then I tried B flat. There were a couple of duplicate glasses so I could play better chords, 5-7. And these are ordinary glass. Crystal rings much too long. I have 2 sets. I play them. I jammed on everything from Waterford to Orifers. but crystal, it's like having the sustaining tone down on the piano. For centuries, people thought you could only play it. But that's only because they never tried distilled water. Gives you much, much better articulation than tap water. Perrier is not bad for light French music, but you have to give you quite the edge. And so here's a little Mozart written for unaccompanied glass, Kirschner Listing 617A, written just before his sacred Ave Verum. The second back to the original theme. The original theme once more. A little ornamentation.